It started innocently enough, I suppose. We had recently adopted our standard poodle, Mia. She was sweet and shy, and I guess I was a little worried about how she would be treated by the other dogs at the park. In fact, I insisted we only walk her after dark. To be honest, I was a little concerned about the other dog owners, too. When someone comes to the park with a Rottweiler or a Pitbull, they engender a kind of respect that is unknown to poodle walkers. People get out of their way. That's all I wanted. There's been a craze over the last several years of breeding poodles with other dogs to make a sort of hybrid dog. A poodle bred with a golden retriever makes a golden doodle. A poodle with a Labrador makes a Labradoodle. I've had in my possession for many years one of the rarest of mystical tomes, a 17th century book containing all manner of incantations. Some of these spells open portals to other dimensions, dimensions populated by the elder gods, Yag-Sothoth, Ithaqua, Dagon, and especially Cthulhu. I decided to breed our poodle with Cthulhu. I would make a Cthulhu. The ritual ceremony was simple enough. A little incense, an invocation. I used my own blood for the sacrifice. It was easy. In retrospect, I should have known that there might be some trouble, a few bugs that needed to be worked out. It went after Ellen first. I suppose it was angry about having been ripped from its own dimension. There was nothing I could do. I've tricked it into going outside. There's enough of the poodle's sensibilities left that it doesn't want to pee in the house. I've locked all the doors and hidden myself in the attic room, but that won't stop it. I can hear it scratching at the back door. I know the doors won't hold. It keeps scratching. Scratching.